If you want to find the secrets of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration. One fateful July night in modern-day Croatia, 1856, a fierce storm of lightning ravaged the earth and the sky. In an insignificant house in the insignificant village of Smiljan, a baby was to be born. And according to a local legend, the midwife, upon seeing the fury of the storm, feared it was a bad omen, and said, "This will be a child of darkness." But with what strength she had left, the mother replied, "No, he will be a child of light." And upon seeing the face of his father decided he should have the name of his own father, Nikola. And out of this great storm, one of the greatest minds of human history was born, and his mother proved right. Nikola Tesla went on to exponentially advance the reach and capacity of human technology by his ability to see deeper and envision a different world than anyone before. It's very difficult to pinpoint exactly what makes a genius, and sometimes the line between genius and insanity is more of a blur. Through certain beliefs and superstitions, such as only staying in hotel rooms divisible by three, or driving around the block three times before entering a building, we can tell that Tesla didn't mind walking this line. But by looking at the universe in this deep, simplistic, and interconnected perspective, he was able to harness the workings and ground of the universe, such as his discovery of alternating current, which allowed electricity to be transported farther and safer than ever before. And after decades of tireless and obsessed work trying to answer certain questions about the nature of the universe and the limits of technology, he built a massive reservoir of patents, documents, and ideas recorded in over 80 trunks stored in his apartment following his death. But what was in these trunks that was so important or so dangerous that the FBI felt it necessary to confiscate all but a few trunks just hours after his death, before family or friends had access to his apartment? Some claim that he had the secrets for accessing a worldwide source of free and clean energy. Some believe he had the blueprints to build something called a death beam, which could have ended World War II. Maybe we'll never know exactly what was in those trunks, but nonetheless, we do need answers. What exactly was Tesla trying to tell us about the universe through his legendary quote on energy, frequency, and vibration? In this video, we are going to examine some of the inventions, ideas, and works of Nikola Tesla and their real-world connection to physics and technology that we can apply today. No one would blame you if you named Nikola Tesla as the greatest inventor in history. We have him to thank for laying the groundwork for so much of the interconnectedness, productivity, and convenience we take for granted in our everyday lives. Tesla was the first person to figure out how to take advantage of the power of resonance and electromagnetic waves. An electromagnetic wave is a pocket of energy traveling at light speed on waves in the electric and magnetic fields. By using electromagnetic waves, Tesla was able to transfer electric current wirelessly from his famed Tesla coil directly to a device using resonance. Resonance is when two objects create waves and are affected by waves in a medium, and through one object reaching a certain frequency, the medium can force the other object to assume the same frequency. So given enough time, the objects resonate together as one. This allowed Tesla to perform his famous demonstration in which he could power a light bulb with absolutely no wires just by holding it in the vicinity of the power source. This way of using a magnetic field to produce and continuously switch the direction of an electric current became one of Tesla's greatest discoveries, known as alternating current. This stood contrast to the much less efficient and less useful form called direct current, favored by Thomas Edison at the time. Little side note, Thomas Edison claimed many of other people's work as his own and actually stole from Tesla's patents, which forced Tesla to put less detail in his patents or not publish them at all. So much of his work he kept private, likely stored in his trunks. When John G. Trump, an engineer working for the National Defense Research Committee, searched through these trunks, he claimed that there was nothing of strategic importance or scientific value to the US contained in what he called 30 trunks. Although according to Tesla, he had 80 trunks containing various works, patents, and letters, which were just about all he had left to his once esteemed name at the time of his death. Though we may not know what is in those trunks, as they are still very under wraps to this day, we can still try to piece together Tesla's understanding through his many works. In 1895, Tesla was ready to display the first radio transmission over 50 miles. But just before the first wireless telegram to New York would have been sent, a fire started in his building, which moved up to destroy his lab and his work with it. Just a year later, in 1856, Marconi released a patent for his first wireless telegram. And although Tesla may not have gotten the credit he deserved, today we can see that his work on the radio fits perfectly with his previous work and his perspective on energy, frequency, and vibration. Radio signals also utilize electromagnetic fields by sending bits of information on a carrier wave of one specific frequency to a receiver which resonates at the same frequency and is therefore able to deconstruct the information via the radio waves. We may take this technology for granted in our modern day, but in Tesla's time he was a visionary, seeing farther into the future and looking closer at the universe than anyone before. In fact, Tesla foretold much of our modern conveniences, once saying, "Through television and telephony, we shall see and hear one another as perfectly as though we were face to face, despite intervening distances of thousands of miles. And the instruments through which we shall be able to do this will be amazingly simple compared to our present telephone. A man will be able to carry one in his vest pocket." This quote goes to show that where others may have seen empty space, Tesla saw a field emanating throughout the entire universe, a field which could carry waves, and with waves at light speed, information in an instant, by which we can magically see each other, communicate, and interact from anywhere in the world. With radio technology eventually being brought from imagination into reality, Tesla wondered, since information can be carried across the world, maybe energy could be too. But instead of looking up to find something to carry the energy, Tesla looked down at the ground. He theorized that if we could find the resonance of the Earth itself and pump energy into it with precisely the same frequency, we could fill the Earth with electricity, free and available for all. Only one problem, for now at least. How and where could you harness enough electricity to power the entire world? For this answer, Tesla looked back up at the Earth's atmosphere. The same electricity that made the lightning storm on which he was born, he believed he could harness via something called the ionosphere. Basically, the ionosphere is a level of Earth's atmosphere which is full of molecules that have been ionized or charged by high-frequency radiation coming from the sun. In his mind, if he could just access the resonance of both the ionosphere and the Earth itself, he could create a renewing cycle of limitless clean energy in a much more efficient and prosperous world altogether. Tesla believed that the ancient Egyptians may have understood this capability of the Earth and built the pyramids to harness and send energy across the land. So with an investment of $150,000 from JP Morgan, Tesla started construction on his own pyramid, the Wardenclyffe Tower. Standing at 187 feet tall, Tesla believed that this megalith was the first key to unlocking the next stage of humanity's future. And with enough time, Tesla's pyramids would be constructed across all nations and landscapes. The initial experiments showed signs of success by being able to create visible sparks and fields of electricity from the atmosphere. And with the vision of a future of free energy and the blueprints of the power of ancient gods, Tesla failed. This is likely because as tall as Tesla's tower was, the ionosphere is at least 50 miles from the Earth's surface, making that a very significant leap for those electrons. And nothing much bigger than a light bulb was ever able to be powered from this, and definitely not from across the world. So this project ended up putting Tesla under $20,000 worth of debt, and eventually Tesla's pyramid was sold for scrap metal. But where Tesla may have failed in practice, his initial theory as to accessing the Earth's resonance may have been more than just a crackpot Egyptian fantasy. For one, the Earth in a way does have a real resonance. This is called Schumann resonance. This basically means that certain frequencies of electromagnetism are able to create a standing wave in the space between the ground and the ionosphere and these waves actually play a vital role in the geophysical processes of the planet. Although, as of now, this is not being researched as a serious technological possibility or source of energy. But nonetheless, Tesla's understanding of the universe as energy, frequency, and vibration has turned out to be true once again. So with this in mind, let's take a deeper and closer look at the universe and see what we may further uncover by thinking in these terms. First off, let's look at what is currently the leading theory to explain all of physics by unifying quantum mechanics and gravity: string theory. String theory posits that all particles, and therefore all matter, are made up of infinitesimally small vibrating strings. These strings vibrate across 10 dimensions, and the specific frequency and shape by which they vibrate controls exactly how this particle interacts with the fields around it and makes up its very essence. And if this theory were correct, it would go to show that the entire universe, from the Big Bang till this very moment, has been one long, beautiful symphony made by the vibration of these strings. But even if this theory is incorrect or fundamentally unknowable, we can still be confident that the universe is in fact made of vibration, as all things have a wavelength, even you. Through studying quantum mechanics, the realm of the absolute smallest, we learn that all particles exist both as a point in space and a wave of probability. This means that for every particle, there is a certain chance of finding it in one place, and then a certain chance of finding it in another, and on, until eventually we stumble across a wave function, which is used to calculate the probability of measuring the particle in any place. So we have to accept that we cannot define both the position and the velocity of a particle, and that it does scientifically exist as a wave spread out across space. The sum of the wave functions of the particles in an object makes up the wave function of the object, and so in this way, we have our own wave function, and all of our particles teleporting at once, therefore us teleporting, is not physically impossible, just extremely unlikely. This may seem a little confusing to our brains, which are predisposed to object permanence, but after all, we must remember that the cosmos is not under any obligation to make sense to us. Nonetheless, thinking in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration has led to the illumination and understanding of much more of the cosmos. Here's just a few examples: gravity waves, phonons, nuclear resonance, celestial vibrations, acoustic resonance, quantum field theory, the electromagnetic spectrum, in the cosmic microwave background. You could never fit all of the scientific and technological implications of vibration into one video, because to do so would be to fit the entire structure and beauty of the cosmos in one video, which would be impossible. But here you can see that from the very tiniest strings vibrating to make up our existence, all the way to the spiraling collision of two black holes creating ripples in space-time itself, everything in physics is vibration. Nikola Tesla was a strong believer that the numbers 3, 6, and 9, along with certain frequencies, were the keys to accessing deeper truths hidden in the universe and discovered with mathematics. Many people discredited or misrepresented Tesla and his ideas because of semi-mystical views like this. But when Tesla said, "If you want to find the secrets of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration," did he mean that there were literal secrets being held in the universe that we could uncover? Or did he mean that generally thinking in terms of these three aspects of vibration would allow us to uncover the universe through the laws of physics? Maybe there's a lot about Tesla that we'll never understand, from the contents of his trunks to his understanding of the pyramids to his obsession with the number 3. But as great as he may have been a fanatic, he was even more great of a genius. His technological advancements paved the way for much of the prosperity and innovation of the 20th century onward. And there's absolutely no doubt that by thinking in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration, humanity has exponentially grasped deep truths about the reality of the cosmos we live in. For one, we now understand that all forms of communication, whether it be sound or light, are carried by waves vibrating through mediums as fundamental to us as the air we breathe. We now understand that the very material of our bodies, hearts, and minds is fundamentally composed of waves or even vibration itself. And through this ordered form of vibration, the cosmos is not just a complete abstraction of space and chaos, as it could have been, but instead an ongoing symphony of order, beauty, and life. By millions of physical processes of energy, frequency, and vibration, we are able to become aware of ourselves as a part of this symphony and can think in these terms to discover the secrets of the cosmos as the cosmos discovers itself. Thanks for watching this video. This is the third part of a four-part series on sound, vibration, and energy, so check the rest of this series by clicking the link above. Please leave a comment if you liked this video or didn't. I love to hear feedback from my viewers. And if deep and meaningful educational topics interest you, then hit the subscribe button. And as always, never stop questioning, talking, and thinking. Thank you.